annual National Operators Meeting for the LEAF program was held in Greece at the Environmental Education Center of Lavrion. National operators from 17 countries around the globe participated in the NOM, which was organized by the Hellenic Society for the Protection of Nature, FEE member in Greece.
We are very happy to have you all here with us today. I hope that we will have plenty of time to get to know each other.
Well, hello everybody. Kalispera, did I get that right?
Yes.
It's a privilege for me to be here. As president of the Foundation for Environmental Education, I've been 18 months now. I can't say new anymore, and the time has just flown by. I'm really, really delighted to be here with all of you, and I'm really looking forward to being part of the discussions and the idea sharing and everything, all the wonderful things that go on at our national operators meetings.
Welcome to Greece. Welcome to Lavrion. Welcome to this wonderful venue, the Environmental Center. It's a pleasure to have you all with us here. I hope we'll have a successful meeting. Thank you all for being here.
Με αφορμή αυτή τη συνάντηση των εθνικών χειριστών του προγράμματος Μαθαίνω για τα δάση, να σας ανακοινώσω την πολύ πρόσφατη πρωτοβουλία του Ελληνικού Κοινοβουλίου και του Υπουργείου Περιβάλλοντος και Ενέργειας που αφορά τα δασικά οικοσυστήματα. Και αυτή αφορά στην έναρξη του διαλόγου για τη συγκρότηση εθνικής στρατηγικής για τα δάση.
Η περιβαλλοντική εκπαίδευση αποτελεί σημαντική παράμετρο για την τοπική αναπτυξιακή στρατηγική του Δήμου μας, που δρά με σεβασμό προς το περιβάλλον. Άλλωστε, το Σούνιο και ο Δήμος μας αποτελούν τον τελευταίο πνεύμα της Ανατολικής Αττικής, αφού στην καρδιά του βρίσκεται ο Εθνικός Δρυμός του Δήμου, ο οποίος είναι ένα μέρος, ένα μεγάλο γεωλογικό και αρχαιολογικό ενδιαφέρον.
There will of course be updates on the Tiny Forest initiative and presentations from fellow LEAF national operators on instances of best practice and new resources, as well as some outdoor activities which we can hopefully share with our networks when we get back to our countries.
Olympic Marine's involvement in sensitivity to nature and the environment is proven by its continuous partnerships with the HSPN, and by the fact that our marina since 1999, as I previously indicated, it, for 70 consecutive years, is awarded with a blue flag.
Wish every success to your meeting. And we have a chance to go on a trip to see some of the very interesting places that Labrador Keys has got. It's a mining area, basically, so we're going to see that.
I will try to give you a brief overview of the evolution of Greek forests and what's happening in Greece at this time. In the Mediterranean biogeographical zone, one of the global hotspots for biodiversity, especially plants, as it contains almost 10% of the planet's plants, about 30,000 different species, and only 1.6% of its total area. Almost 300 indigenous tree species, two-thirds of which are endemic.
The Environmental Education Center of Lavrion is housed within the old industrial complex of the French mining company, which operated the Lavrion mines around the end of the 19th and the beginning of the 20th century. The complex has now been converted to a technological and cultural park, and many of the buildings have been restored. During the meeting, technical issues of the program were analyzed with presentations from the participants and selected invited speakers.
It's been a very busy year for the program, fantastically busy, lots of great developments.
Skoven i skolen means basically directly translated the forest in the school. The website has all these different approaches, so you can look either from a teacher point of view or a pupil point of view. It is like a catalog of teaching materials It's very easily accessible. You could just go in and print out whatever you need for going out teaching. It's built basically upon a theory that teaching outside the classroom gives more to pupils and gives more to learning.
Right now we are working with 20 eco schools as part of the Foundation for Environmental Education programs, and we are planning this year we are going to involve at least two colleges. This is teacher training colleges to be on board, and that's why we thought of joining the second program. This is LEAF, and we had a lot of reasons for looking for LEAF because we are working with Forest Pro. We've been working with Forest for quite a long time, and we thought that LEAF is really the right program for us now after the eco schools.
What we did is now how we started this project is that one is that we want to train the students on how to identify what are some of the native trees that is endemic in Malaysia or even in the state itself, and also preparation of the soil condition. And as well, we're bringing in NGOs, the government agencies, and as well as the school together to do this project. We've signed an MOU with the state to make all the schools, all the 316 school or 14 school eco schools. And we are actually now introducing Tiny Forest at the LEAF program to eco schools that we have registered.
Not only important to place a pocket park or let's say a tiny forest, I like this expression a lot, or an urban forest in the city, but you have to develop a number of preconditions to be met, requirements, so as to understand the local environment, the urban environment, the city environment at the first stage, and then decide where to make a forest, a small forest. The city is a living organism. It's the city, the buildings, the environment, the materials, but most importantly is the human ecosystem which has been developed in the city.
You can grow a tiny forest anywhere. Then we had to find a place which local governments will allow us to do some research and to plant a tiny forest with these methods. And I just got the results in a report. We did a lot of research, and the research was about, well, is there biodiversity in a tiny forest?
If I was going to say to you in one sentence what are we doing in this network is forest education through the forest. Our motto is go to the forest and learn from the forest through the forest.
12 different pathways of sustainability. For each one of our pathways, we have some defining terms that are there, and you can see what we have for learning about forests, and we talk about what are forests. And we also talk, link to the FEES, Foundation for Environmental Education's LEAF website.
In Cyprus, we deal with forest fires. You know, I've been talking about fires. And our day of action, which was on the 21st of March, involved again fires. So we had a fire car coming into a school. The children would go on it, and the people who fight fires, I told them exactly how they go about it. And of course, they tell them that leave the fighting of fires to the professionals. You work on prevention and mitigation of the consequences.
This is something that we can all, or in parts, work together to do things like that. Because a lot of you have interesting ideas that perhaps you cannot take them forward alone. But if you find somebody else to support it, that may have a connection with a proper sponsor, the doors open up. And this is exactly the big benefit of us being together in this big family.
The participants were enchanted by their specially guided visit to the archaeological site of Sunio and the Temple of Poseidon. The last day, all the participants walked on the educational path through the National Park of Sunio.
Try and make the invisible visible.
Mining activities in the Brodalavrion area dates back to the 4th millennium BC. It reached its peak in the 5th and 4th centuries BC, when Lavrian silver was the foundation for the premises of the Athenian city-state. Then it declined, and by Roman times it was but a memory. Today, from trenches and tunnels to ingenious systems for enriching the ore using water, the remnants of the ancient mining facilities are scattered throughout the Sunio National Park. Thank you.
you're either going to save one of your friends, or you're either going to take the seed back to the nest, okay? So basically, when you hear me say, because at one point I'm going to freeze everything. And basically, that's it. So, everybody clear with the rules?
We have a network here who are attaining the goals that you're talking about doing at the school level, and make sure they realize how important it is, the work we do. It's not just about greening urban centers. That's, yes, that's a part of it, but there's children growing up in those urban centers.
I think it's been a really excellent mix of helping us, you know, using our brain and thinking and planning, but also that interaction and then the activity outside. So it's been great. So as I said at the start, this is my first Leave Nom, and I've loved it. So finally, my thank you is to all of you for all the hard work and amazing things you do in your countries, and thank you for making me feel so welcome here.
We are here for you and the members of the steering committee as well. We're here to help and we're here to hear whatever you need from us, but we also need input from you if the program is to get better and grow, because you are the guys that are doing the work. Right there with the teachers, with the children, you're working with it, so we need to know from you what is important. So we're here for you anytime. You can contact us or through Barry, but we're here to help.
Learning About Forest is a big program talking about social, cultural, economic and ecologic aspects of how forest develops and how people are in contact with forest. So this broad connection with forest absolutely helps us understanding our relationship with the forest. Hopefully this also brings the young generation better in contact with the forest and understanding the balance between all these different values. So it's absolutely a good and nice situation to visit different countries for different years for these national operators meetings to see the situation locally.
I'm so happy to see how this network has been growing year after year. And we have new lovely members, and some members who haven't been very active during the late years are coming back. It's lovely. And also the program was very inspiring because there were examples of projects which were very, very different. And I like the way my colleagues in different countries are inspiring the children and teachers in so different ways. The Tiny Forest is a good example of that, and also the regional cooperation with different countries.
We've been here in Laveron over the last few days at a meeting to discuss and share ideas about one of our programmes, Learning About Forests. It's been a fantastic few days. People from over 20 countries have joined us, and we've been delighted that our host HSPN from here in Greece has been able to support this meeting. We've shared ideas, we've gone for walks in forests, we've done some speed dating where we all shared ideas with many people from many other parts of the world. We've learned a lot, we've experienced the beautiful weather here and the wonderful Greek hospitality, and I think we all feel a little bit sad that we are now coming to the end of our Learning About Forests National Operators meeting.
Ha ha ha!